Now that you've made it to 2018, you deserve a breakfast of champions, even if you had a rough night out.
Well, fortunately for all of us, here are some hangover cures that are right in your kitchen pantry is chef and nutritionist Diane Hendricks. First of all, Diane.
Ready?
We've been wanting to do that. So, yeah. All right. So what do we do? So we're not hungover, but I'm not gonna lie. There have been past New Year's days where I have. So hope my parents aren't watching. But no. Okay. So what do we do? What's the first step? New Year's Day. What do we do to recover?
Well, I was thinking about it. I did a little research. There's really no magic potion. I mean, the best for you. I know. I wish there was as well. So what I came up with is to rest, rehydrate, and replenish.
Okay.
I mean, just the three R's for hangovers.
Sure.
So rest, you want to get your rest. Go back to bed if you can.
At 10 o'clock Eastern, please.
Yes, at 10 a.m., thank you. Yes,
you can call into work if you have to. I mean, you should have thought about that the night before, but there you go. And then to rehydrate, I mean, you want to drink water, but you don't want to drink it too fast, especially if you're feeling sick, so do that slowly. And then we have, like, electrolyte and vitamin and mineral drinks, like coconut water, a green drink, some cranberry juice, and a virgin Bloody Mary. I don't believe the hair of the dog works. I think it just kind of starts it over again. I mean, you may be using new alcohol, but it's eventually going to go back to the old alcohol. Yeah, and ginger and peppermint are really good. And pickle juice. They do it in Poland, man, and they drink a lot of vodka, and they all feel good. So so pickle juice, a couple of shots in the morning is supposed to work as well.
All right.
I'm going to start having that with my coffee.
So sometimes, you know, if you're hungover, I'm just hypothetically, you know, you're really hungry. So, like, what about that? Anything that kind of cures it, or what are your thoughts there? I see some food here.
Yeah, well, think about what you're craving.
Delicious.
You're probably craving burgers and, you know, greasy food, but that's actually not a good thing.
Okay.
So, you know, salmon has omega-3 fatty acids and some cream cheese. Number one is really protein, because your body is breaking down the protein into amino acids to really break, to fix your liver. Go ahead. I know you had your eye on that the whole time. So protein type of things, like scrambled eggs and salmon and chicken soup. And over there I have cottage cheese, which is really fantastic, because this particular one, Muna, is very high in protein. It's got, you know, low sugar and fresh fruits, and it's really delicious. So protein, a good combination of protein and vitamin and mineral foods. A turkey burger. I mean, you're craving a burger, go for something a little bit leaner so you don't have all that grease setting in. And this is in case you just don't feel like chewing.
So what is this?
It's just a smoothie mixed with bananas, foods that have a lot of potassium.
What about like an Oreo smoothie, no?
Yeah, throw some Oreos in there. I wouldn't mind.
And tell us about the Dig In box.
It's Dig In with Chef Diane Hendricks. Just like the chefs come on and I have a restaurant, that's my restaurant. I just launched a subscription box service with the largest gardening and website in the country. So you can grow indoors 12 months out of the year.
Yeah, we were talking about that because I'm like, okay, when is this, like, fake basil?
No.
Todd wants a box.
12 months out of the year.
How do you get one then?
You go to diginonline.com and you can register. You can do 1 month, 3 months. It's really awesome. So you get gardening and culinary and oils and spices and gadgets and all that. And there's an egg separator in there, Peter.
Oh, good.
So I didn't realize that. So later on we're going to be using that. So hold on to that.
Because he's going to need some tips.
Right. And how far in advance does somebody need to start planting if they're going to have a hangover?
Yeah, I don't know. I can't even answer that. You stumped me on that one.